Assalamu alaikum dear students, hope you all are well at home. So as we have already started a new chapter from your 12th standard physics textbook, that is chapter number 10, magnetic fields due to electric current, and today's lecture is a part 2 of the same chapter. Now in the previous video lecture I have discussed with you some introduction part of this chapter, where in that we have studied regarding how a magnetic field is produced around a current carrying wire through an experiment that was known as Oersted experiment. So through that video experiment I have explained you that how a magnetic field is produced around a current carrying wire. Then next to that we were having a solenoid, that I have explained you what is the solenoid. After that, a very important part of this chapter was nothing but what is right hand rule. That also I have explained you that the right hand rule is states that consider if a magnetic needle is held in close proximity of a current carrying wire, it shows the direction of magnetic field circling around the wire. Imagine that current carrying wire is grabbed with your right hand, as you can see in this diagram, with thumb pointing in the direction of the current, that is I. Then your fingers curl around in the direction of the magnetic field, as you can see in this diagram. So this is called as right hand thumb rule that we have already studied in previous lecture. That all was the introduction part. Now let's jump to the main subtopic of this chapter, that is magnetic force and magnetic field. So before understanding the magnetic forces, let's understand what is magnetic field. The magnetic force influences only those charges that are already in motion. It is transmitted by magnetic field. Both magnetic fields and magnetic forces are more complicated than electric fields and electric forces. The magnetic field does not point along the direction of the source of the field. Instead, it points in a particular direction. In addition, the magnetic force acts in a direction that is perpendicular to the direction of the field. In comparison, both the electric force and electric field point directly towards or away from the charge. Now, the present discussion will deal with simple situation in which the magnetic field is produced by a current of charge in a wire. Certain materials such as copper, silver, and aluminium are conductors that allow charge to flow freely from place to place. If an external influence establishes a current in a conductor, the current generates a magnetic field. For a long straight wire, the magnetic field has a direction that encircles the wire on a plane perpendicular to the wire, as you can see in this diagram. The strength of magnetic field decreases with distance from the wire. The arrows in figure 2 represent the size and the direction of magnetic field for a current moving in a direction indicated. Now the figure 2 shows an end view with the current coming towards the reader, while second figure provides a three-dimensional view of the magnetic field at one position along the wire, as you can see here. See here, figure A, an end view with current flowing towards the viewer, and figure B shows a three-dimensional view of magnetic field of a long wire. Now, how does the magnetic field interact with a charged object? If the charge is at rest, there is no interaction. If the charge moves, however, it is subjected to a force, the size of which increases in direction proportional with the velocity of charges. The force has a direction that is perpendicular both to the direction of motion of the charge and to the direction of the magnetic field, as you can see in this diagram. There are two possible precisely opposite directions for such a force for a given direction of motion. This apparent ambiguity is resolved by the fact that one of the two directions applies to the force on a moving positive charge, while the other direction applies to the force on a moving negative charge. Now, figure or this diagram illustrates the direction of the magnetic force on positive charges and on negative charges as they move in a magnetic field that is perpendicular to the motion. Fine? Now, depending on the initial orientation of the particle velocity to the magnetic field, charges having constant speed in a uniform magnetic field will follow a circular or helical path. Now, electric current in wires are not the only source of magnetic fields. Naturally occurring minerals exhibit magnetic properties and have magnetic fields. These magnetic fields result from the motion of electron in the atoms of the material. They also results from a property of electrons called the magnetic dipole moment that we have already studied in standard 11th, which is related to intrinsic spin of individual electrons. In most materials, little or no field is observed outside the matter because of the random orientation of various constituent atoms. In some materials such as iron, however, atoms within certain distances tends to become aligned in one particular direction. Now, as in our previous video lecture, we have seen one experiment where we have considered two wires having current passing through them. Now, we found that in the wire A repel each other, and those in the diagram B, the wire B, come closer, that is they attract each other as soon as the current starts. Now, in the second diagram where you are having wire A and wire 2, so how can one account for the force on the neighboring current carrying wire? The magnetic field due to current in the wire 1 at any point on wire 2 is directed into the plane of the paper. The electrons flow in a direction opposite to the conventional current. Then the wire 2 experiences a force vector of F towards wire 1. Fine? Now, as we have discussed the right hand rule, so you can see here the very first figure, very first diagram, that is force in the direction that thumb points. So curl finger as if rotating vector V, where V is the velocity of the electron or the charged particle, into vector B, where B is the magnetic field, thumb in the direction of the force. Now see the second diagram, that is the force direction in outward from palm. So here point thumb in direction of velocity, finger in magnetic field direction, then palm direction is the direction of the force on charge. So that is the right hand thumb rule. So finally we can say that vector of F is equal to Q, that is charge, vector of V into vector of B. Fine. Now how this force comes here? See, basically when we have studied electrostatics in our 11th standard, so we have found that the force is nothing but charge into electric field, that is F is equal to Q E, where E is the electric field or electric field intensity. Similarly, here when we are in magnetic field, so here the term Q is replaced by the magnetic strength, that is M, and basically magnetic strength is plus minus M. When this magnetic strength is charge into velocity, so finally when we are having electric field with us, so F is equal to Q into E, that E is the electric field, and when we are in magnetic field, so it will be replaced by capital B, and instead of that Q charge, electric charge, it will be replaced by charge into velocity, because SI unit of pole strength or magnetic strength is nothing but ampere meter. So ampere is stand for current and meter is for velocity or distance. So finally you will get that finally force is nothing but the magnetic force will be here QVB, that is QV, Q vector of V into or cross product of vector of B. So hope you will understand the relation between electric field and force in electric field and force in magnetic field. Fine. So from all this discussion, you must have realized that the direction of vector of V, vector of B and vector of F follow a vector cross product relationship. Actually, the magnetic force, that is Fm, on the electron with a charge negative E moving with velocity vector of V in a magnetic field vector of B is given by, see the equation number 1 here that I have highlighted by yellow color, that is vector of Fm, that is vector of magnetic field, is equal to minus E in the bracket vector of V cross product of vector of B. So in general, for a charge Q, the magnetic force will be, now see the second equation, that is 10.2, that magnetic force, vector of magnetic force, is equal to Q in the bracket vector of V cross product of vector of B. If both electric field, that is vector of E, and the magnetic field, that is vector of B, are present, the net force on charge Q moving with the velocity vector of V in is equal to, that is final, the net force capital F, vector of capital F, is equal to Q in the bracket vector of E plus cross product of vector of V and vector of B. Fine. So when you open the bracket, so we will have Q vector of E plus Q in the bracket cross product of vector of V into vector of B, that is finally the net force is equal to electric force, that is vector of Fe plus vector of Fm, where vector of Fe is the electric force and vector of Fm is magnetic force. So finally the net force, it will be sum of all these two force, that is sum of electric force and sum of magnetic force. So finally this is the force, net force, which is called Lorentz force. Now Lorentz force law. So both the electric field and magnetic field can be defined from the Lorentz force law. As you can see here, vector of F is equal to Q vector of E, when this term is called as electric force, plus Q vector of V cross product of vector of B, where this term is called as magnetic force. So the electric force is straightforward, being in the direction of the electric field if the charge Q is positive. But the direction of the magnetic part of force is given by the right hand rule, that is just now I have explained you. So as you can see in the diagram 1, that is the electric force QE. Then in the next diagram we are having magnetic force of magnitude QVB sine theta perpendicular to both V and B away from Weaver. So this is all regarding the Lorentz force law. Fine. Now there are interesting consequences of the Lorentz force law. These are, number one, if the velocity vector of V of a charged particle is parallel to the magnetic field vector of B, the magnetic force is zero. Fine. Now the second, if the charge is stationary, that is velocity is equal to zero or vector of V is equal to zero, so the force will be also zero even if magnetic field is not equal to zero. So these are the two interesting consequences of the Lorentz force law. Now from the very last equation, that was the Lorentz force. So from the last equation, it may be observed that the force on the charge due to electric field depends on the strength of electric field and the magnitude of the charge. However, the magnetic force depends on the velocity of the charge and the cross product of the velocity vector of V. The magnetic field vector B and the charge Q. So consider the vector V and vector of B with certain angle between them. Then V cross product of vector of B will be a vector perpendicular to the plane containing the vector B and vector V. As you can see in this diagram, this is the cross product in the direction of the unit vector perpendicular to both vector V and vector B. Thus, the vectors V and vector F are always perpendicular to each other. Hence, F dot vector of V is equal to zero for any magnetic field vector B. Magnetic force, that is vector of Fm, is thus perpendicular to the displacement, and hence the magnetic force never does any work on moving charges. The magnetic forces may change in the direction of the motion of a charged particle, but they can never affect the speed. Interestingly, equation 10.2 leads to the definition of unit of vector B. So from equation 10.2, vector of F is equal to Q mod of vector of B cross product of vector of V n cap is equal to QVB sine theta n cap. Now why this sine theta? Because V is a cross product of B. V vector of V cross product of vector of B. So when you remove the cross product, so you will have sine theta here. So finally, we can say that if the force F is 1 Newton acting on the charge of 1 Coulomb moving with a speed of 1 meter per second perpendicular to B, vector of B, then we can define the unit vector of B, that is B is equal to F upon QV, as I have already explained you this. So unit of B is, as it is force, so force, unit of force is Newton upon Q is the coulomb, velocity is meter per second. So second will come in numerator. So finally, Newton dot second upon coulomb dot meter. So dimensionally we can have B is equal to F upon QV. So finally we can say that is, this SI unit is called Tesla. That is, 1 Tesla is equal to 10 raised to 4 Gauss, where Gauss is not an SI unit, but it is used as a convenient unit. So this is all regarding the magnetic field. Now let's have one example. That is, a charged particle travels with a velocity vector of V through a uniform magnetic field vector of B, as shown in the following figure. In three different situations, what is the direction of magnetic force, that is vector of Fm, due to the magnetic field on the particle? So let's discuss it one by one. So in the diagram number one, as you can see here, so here in figure A, the direction of the vector V cross product of vector of B will be in the positive y direction. Hence, magnetic force, that is vector of Fm, will be in the positive y direction. Fine? That is, as you can see here, vector of V is along with x direction, then vector of B is opposite to of z direction. So finally, the magnetic force will be nothing but in the positive y direction. So this is the direction of the magnetic field according to the figure A. Now next to that, we are having figure B. As you can see here, V is along with the z direction, B, the magnetic field, is along with the y direction, and the velocity is opposite to of the z direction. So what will be the direction of the magnetic force? So V cross product of vector of B will be in the positive x direction. Hence the force, that is magnetic force, vector of Fm, will be in the same direction, that is positive x direction. Then next to that, we are having figure C here. So in the C diagram or C figure, we are having V, vector of V and vector of B are anti-parallel. The angle between them is 180, as you can see in the figure C, and because sine 180 is 0, so magnetic force, that is vector of Fm, will be equal to 0. So these are the example to find the direction of the magnetic force, that is Fm, due to the magnetic field on the particles. So let's stop here. This is what we have to study today, that is all regarding the magnetic forces and magnetic fields.